Cloud computing essentially defines the use of centralized resources connected over the internet to run IT infrastructure. This presents a paradigm shift in how IT has been managed for years, likely disrupting the $4 trillion global IT hardware and software market. Global data expansion is in full force, which is one of the strongest tailwinds driving adoption of cloud computing. Nearly 180 zettabytes of data will be created, stored, and processed in a year by 2025. Over the last 10 years, data has been growing at a 40% growth rate. There is a very strong correlation between global data generated and the revenues of public cloud companies, which really shows how enterprises are consuming more and more software to make sense of their information. Naturally, data asset generation likely won't slow, and we believe that's the strongest tailwind to cloud computing there is. Hyperscale data centers are essentially these gigantic computing facilities that pool computing, storage, networking technologies to deliver the capacity needed to support modern era technology. Hyperscale processing is the backbone of all modern computing, enabling streaming, lag-free communications, unlimited storage, immersive experiences, and more. What's exciting about hyperscaling is that these facilities are a hotbed for tech innovation. Hyperscalers are redefining everything from chip architecture to networking components to software architecture in order to support low-cost, data-heavy computation. Today, thanks to their hyperscale processing capabilities, big tech companies are turning into toll seekers of the digital economy. Cloud businesses essentially run on a subscription model, which is an incredibly efficient business model. On one end, cloud businesses allow software buyers to manage spending better, offer flexibility, and result in low upfront costs. On the other end, for software companies, the model allows for cost predictability, improved stickiness, which all can result in better margins. We see that software companies pioneering subscription models have incredible fundamental metrics. For example, net retention rates, which is essentially the incremental dollar spent by existing customers on contract renewals, is high for SaaS companies. Another metric we track at GlobalX is magic number, which essentially tracks the incremental dollar that companies make for every dollar spent on sales and marketing. The best SaaS companies are capable of delivering incredible margins and profitability at scale. The global shift to the public cloud is just getting started. At the end of 2022, cloud is expected to be roughly a $500 billion market in total. That includes software, platforms, and infrastructure. By 2026, the global cloud computing market is expected to top $1 trillion in spending. Despite that, we believe the runway for growth is quite long. Last year, global businesses spent nearly $4.5 trillion around the world on IT. We believe nearly 80% of that spending is addressable by cloud computing technologies. By 2030, we estimate that the global cloud computing spending could easily top up to 30% penetration of the total IT market, which tells us how early we still are in this cloud computing journey. As digitization expands, cybersecurity challenges are also evolving. Hybrid working and the broad increase of digital activity is throwing unique challenges for enterprises to deal with. Moreover, we're also witnessing one of the worst times in terms of attacks right now. Cloud-deployed security solutions also allow enterprises to benchmark their operations against industry standards, improving overall safety. Learning from attacks other companies face is a great way to leverage data to improve defenses. Security spending is expected to grow nearly 10% this year to $170 billion. It is expected to top almost $400 billion by the end of the decade. The security market is extremely fragmented. Nearly 50% of the market is attributed to custom services. Meanwhile, COVID-19 surfaced unique security challenges for enterprises to deal with. Software solutions that help enterprises fix these emerging problems are growing at a much faster rate. Some of these areas, such as network security, cloud security, endpoint security, data security, will likely continue to grow at an accelerated pace in the near future. We believe the widely fragmented security industry will also witness a rapid wave of consolidation as large security companies look to buy smaller players to fill gaps. Nearly 65% of the total software market is still outside the cloud. We think the cloud, big data, and the security market is still in its early majority stages. These technologies will likely continue to offer investors exciting opportunities to discover growth through this decade.